as we're on this Thai Airways flight from Bangkok up to Beijing. Okay, so Beyond ATC is not happy, so we won't be using that on today's flight. Something to do with saying runway 1 doesn't exist, but there we go. Right, let's get this flight underway. And I'll give details as and when we can. Okay, it's above your payload parking brake battery switch. See overhead, huh? Oh, that's the overhead helmet. Okay, battery switch on, primary flight computers auto guard closed. Yep, that's good. Thrust asymmetry auto, AP gen switch on. On, cabin utility on. Left and right bus tie switches on auto. Generator control switches on, pack ups on, and APU start on, which I've done. Nav light on, leg lights is needed, cup lights and emergency lighting, armed guard closed. Left and right pack controls on auto, ADIRU is to be on, that's the one that I can find. This happens every single time. Where is the damn thing? Oh yeah, it's all right over here. That's right.
So was there a bird in the chimney?
Okay, FMC initialized position. Should all come on in a minute. The appropriate systems. What's going on over here? Brighter, be nice. There we go. Right, still waiting for the systems to come online. It's a bit reluctant at the moment. There we go, FMC. So we're in VTBS, VTBS. VTBS, and we're heading to ZBAA. Oh. 2x, execute, performance initialization, CFE rate, so it's fine, 0. Cruising altitude today on this flight, I don't think I've even looked. loaded the appropriate fuel amounts, have I? Fuel on board that we need a lot more fuel than that. We're going to need 77223 on the fuel today. Add the payload, estimated zero fuel rate 442.5 on zero fuel rates. There we go. So yeah, cruising altitude today is expected to be 87,000 feet. All right, we'll switch our over to 35 then. Okay, cost index is 113. Performance calculate. So we are departing a runway 01 right via the Albor WAC-K departure. Execute. And then from Airbus it's R474. Takes us to Lavos. Lavos. 474. Set off. Yeah. All right, up yours. We'll go to T-back. T-back. R474. Thank you. R343. Set off. My flight stick just falling off my legs. From Nifty, it's R343 again. Doesn't like that. Up yours once more. To Gosma. Doesn't like us using the same airway twice in a row, does it? W82, I've noticed. To Upmet. W56, Whiskey 56, Lieben. And then it's going to be directed Nidku, because it's not going to like me putting the airway in again. Nidku. Or again, Dugib. Dugib. And then we come to our arrival into ZBAA, which is going to be on 36 left. As I said, 36 left via the Dig 9Z. Dig line Z A arrival. Execute. Legs. Thrust limits. Flaps 5. V speeds all set. Let's just make sure the flight plan makes sense. Step through the flight plan. Zoom out a bit. Let's make sure there's no silly nonsense. Looks legit. Gets a little bit swirly-whirly around there. Sure we'll manage. There we go. Maps. Sets. Render heat. Don't fly this enough to know where everything is. Sure, window heat was up. Ah, here it is. Window heat. There we go. Primary left and right. Engine hydraulics are on. Shape R. All the others are off. No smoking signs. Auto on. Seatbelt signs auto on. EEC mode switches on to norm, which they are. Engine start selectors normal. Auto start switch is on. Left fuel pump. Any fuel in there. Equipment cooling, gas per switch ring, engine anti-ice equipment cooling auto, gas per switch is on, recycs are on, flight deck auto control, auto trim switches on, left and right control ISO shutdown switches on auto, engine bleeds on, auto pressurization panel set auto. Latest attaining FMC program, done all that to set this. So we're cruising today, what did we say, altitude of 35,000 feet. Okay, be difficult. Flight director's on. Yeah. And I've selected. Flight director's initial climb. Brake ejector takeoff set. Transponder TCAS. Okay, that's all activated. Take off taxi briefing complete, cam doors closed. Cenepay disconnected. Right, electric demand hydraulic on. Primary C1s, C2s on. Left electric on. Air demands on to auto. Seatbelt, speaking light on. Refuel check. Not where the bloody recall button is on here now. I thought it was up here somewhere. That's the one. Okay, ready for push and start. Connections removed. There we Brilliant. So we're just powering up the aircraft nicely now. Right, generator controls on, APU selector switch off, engine stack selectors normal, left and right packs auto, sensor isolation, engine flaps. Stabilizer trim, flight control is recall. Wing engine cast Tech-Selects. On. Straight on. Turn offs that's needed. Landing lights on. Strobe lights. Transformer mode. Everything else is all set. Are you ready to taxi on out and depart? I just get a break off. It'd be good. This is when it always gives me. There we go. It's off. Days. As we prepare to say farewell to Bangkok Airport, heading on out. To Beijing, up in China. Reasonable weather here in Bangkok. elapsed time is on this clock, is it here? I think it's that one. Ooh, that thing climbs like a rocket. Chuck. Lights off, runways, taxiways off. Standard barriers on. The glacier back relaxes the flight. Super science off. Well, so now relax and try the flights. We'll see you on that side. Okay, welcome back, aviators. We will be beginning our descent down into Beijing very shortly. Runway 36 left approach. It's the one we want. Descending to 2,900. There we go. As we begin approach into Beijing, weather we can expect in Beijing today is very light winds. Temperature's only about 6 degrees, and skies are clear. So, looking good. All right, so we come down to here. We will go to there, set our landing speeds. 200 on that. Radio altimeter is set. We are descending. Oh, we're quite a bit above the profile by the looks of things. So we're descending quite a rate at the moment. Although that said, we are out from our destination. So yeah, inbound of course from Bangkok on this flight that has been 3.5 hours. And we're still good on the fuel. As you can see, the satellite imagery in this area isn't particularly great. Yeah, you can see there where it sort of goes from default generic to, yeah. I don't know if that's going to improve on the new Microsoft Flight Simulator. You would hope so, right? Be nice if it did. But won't hold out too much hope. Okay, I'm going to stick the speed brakes out because we need to get back on that profile because we are quite a bit above it at the moment, so... We'll slow the plane down, which will enable us to, wow, really nosedive. Ooh. Yeah, we know the speed brake's extended because I want to get back on the, I can't believe you can descend at that rate on the speed brake. That seems ridiculous. Mind you, we are quite light on this air. Oh my god, we're almost in a nosedive. Look at that. That's an insane rate of descent. 5,000, yeah, that can't be right. That's pretty much an emergency descent rate, but we're going to get back. The good thing is we're going to get back on profile pretty damn quick doing that. There we go. And before you know it, we are back. We are back, we are back, we are back. There we go. The speed brake as we continue at a more sedate descent rate. So no beyond ATC because it threw a wobbly in Bangkok about recognizing runways. So yeah, a bit of a pain. Let's just arm that speed brake ready because I don't forget about it otherwise. Yeah, you can see the scenery difference there. As I say, I don't know if it's going to be addressed. Obviously, I suppose they can only use the data that they have available. So if the data's not there, it's not there, right? Yeah, it just looks... Yeah, I mean, if you're going to have generic default scenery, I mean, come on, you can make a bit more effort than that. I mean... You make it blend a bit better, that's all I'm saying. Well, not so much blend, but you can at least make the actual actually seem a bit more believable than just splodges of. I don't know. Or actually, you can see, well, I don't know what's going on. Yeah, God, that's terrible. This tile popping seems. I had this on yesterday's flight, flying from San Jose to Chicago. I don't know what's going on at the moment. Probably not helped by my absolutely useless internet here. It's quite remote. I mean, well, I suppose for the UK it's not really. I mean, it's just like, as far as fibre broadband goes, it's like the land that time forgot round here, to be honest. Yeah, a bit frustrating. Anyways, we are just descending nicely down into Beijing. Got to get this done, so I've got to go off and do some cooking. I'm going to be cooking myself some kugelis. So those of you of a Lithuanian heritage or familiar with Lithuania will know what I'm talking about there. First time I tried making it for myself. It's a friend of mine, she told me she'd make the pancakes. I guess she doesn't have faith in my ability to good kugelis, but there we go. Anyway, we are over China. Should be talking about Chinese stuff, really. What can I say about China? Well, if we had some nice satellite imagery, I could probably say a bit more than just it looks flat and the weather's nice today, albeit cold. Only, what did I say? 6 degrees, 6 degrees. Although, I guess in real time at the moment, it's night time in Beijing. So, yeah, that kind of makes sense. And it is sort of heading quickly towards our winter. Okay, so ILS 111.7. Need to dial that in on the dials, do I? Or is it automatic? I'm trying to remember on this plane now. Hold on. As I think it's a radio nav feature, isn't it, on this thing? Hold on. It's, yeah, there we go. It is. Must remember to activate the approach mode, because I didn't yesterday on my flight into Chicago, so that made it a bit of a messy approach. Never mind. Anyway, as I said, lovely weather here. It's a cold, crisp autumnal day here in China. As we obviously a little bit colder than what the weather was in Bangkok. Wait a minute. So the weather in Bangkok. Yeah, so it's like 32 degrees in Bangkok. And here in Beijing, it's less. It is less. So yeah, from the tropical climes of Thailand to the chilly climes of Beijing, I guess. Obviously China does get very cold in the winter in certain parts. I wish they would give us some decent satellite imagery for these parts of the world, because it ruins it. Looks so ugly. I mean, I'd say it looks even worse than FSX, to be honest with you. I mean, at least that, with your Orbix global scenery, you could make it at least look, well, more believable than that, put it that way. Well, there we go. That's a little. See, that there's areas that have got nice satellite representation, and there's areas that just haven't. But annoying. Anyway, as I said, we are inbound on this Thai Airways flight to Bangkok. Currently flying at an altitude of 16,000 feet. We should be on the ground before too long. Wow, it's a lot faster than that other plane. Jeez. Weird. So it's like it's not moving at all, isn't it? Okay, so the weather is 0121 on the trim. Slowing down nicely because the runway is literally just there in front of us. Seatbelts all on. We will be arriving in to Beijing momentarily. Mountains over there at least. Try and get some Ladies and gentlemen, we'll shortly be arriving into Beijing. Preparation for landing. Please ensure tray tables are stowed. Seatbelts fastened, seats in upright position, armrests are down. And all the other stuff they usually ask you to do. The toilets are now off limits. So if you need a pee, then, well, it's too late really, isn't it? Okay. As we prepare for our approach into Beijing. 153 landing speed. Nice. We've got to get down to 2,900 feet. We are on profile perfectly. We will arm the localizer. There we go. Then obviously in due course we'll arm the approach mode. We've got traffic in front of us somewhere. Just passing off to our side. Don't have the traffic in sight. Fly over, I guess this must probably be the suburbs of Beijing by now. As we continue our descent. Down. Lights on, auto brakes set, everything else is armed. We can think about extending the flaps shortly. In fact, we'll start to do that now, I think. Keep that rate of descent going. There we go. We can arm the approach. We'll start slowing the aircraft to final approach speed. And we're in sight. We're configuring it a little bit early, I guess. Let's get that gear down then. See it, so the scenery here is a bit it's a shame, really. So yeah, reconfigured early. Get Sky Dolly recording before we forget. Flaps are full, speed is good. We are fully configured. As I say, a little bit early. We are descending on the glide slope for our approach into Beijing. Momentarily.
2,500.
Yeah, no satellite imagery for Beijing. I mean, come on. It's disappointing. We'll kick the auto throttle off in a minute. Why can't we land on the other runway? Why do we have to land on this one? Typical, right? Bit annoying. Why has it become... imagine living in those right at the end of the runway there. God, well, that's fun. And those high-rises. I don't think you'd want to, really, would you? I mean, yeah, especially at a busy airport like that. I mean, if a plane comes down short, I mean, it's going right... They can't be there in real life, surely, can they?
1,000.
That'd be ridiculous. Gear down, 3 green, auto brake armed, everything else armed that needs to be armed. We are literally going to skim the tops of those high-rises. I mean, oh my good God. I mean, literally skim the top of them. A bit precarious, isn't it? Yeah.
Approaching minimums.
Shut up.
Minimums.
Yeah, continue. Coming in high, coming in very high.
50, 30, 20, 10.
There we go. Pretty decent landing, I think. Always seem to manage to land this plane quite nicely. There we go. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Beijing. Well, I can't believe they got those big massive buildings right next to the airport. Seriously, come on. What's that all about? Can't be right, can't be right, can't be right. Anyway, let's try and... oh my God, where have we got it? God. This is one of those airports. Shut up. Try and turn that off for you in a minute, because that is ever so massively annoying. Yeah, it's turned itself off, thank God for that. Right, so we'll go and park over here somewhere. Sort of like, there's a couple of terminals here, so should be able to find one relevant to us if we carry on down this taxiway a fair way. So yeah, we are on the happily on the ground in Beijing. Take those errors off. We have arrived, everybody. Welcome to Beijing, the capital of China. There's no way. I don't know. I tell you what, if you like flying, aviation, you get one of these on the side here. You have fabulous views. Just a lot of noise. A busy international airport. I mean, yeah, I suppose. It's not beyond the realms of feasibility. But anyway, as I said already, we are on the ground here in Beijing. Welcome, welcome, welcome. I have no idea what welcome is in Chinese, or Thai for that matter. Should go and park next to that Korean Air flight, I guess. there seems to be a distinct lack of terminal buildings. Although I don't think there are supposed to be any here. I think it's just empty apron. But I tell you what, we're going to stick ourselves right here on this remote sound, because I can't be asked to taxi the other 5,000 miles over to the main terminal, which you can see there's that distant speck on the horizon there. So this parking spot is as good as any. Passengers are just going to have to get the bus. All right. Oops, we've overshot the... Anyway, let's go to our replay and have a look at the landing, shall we? Which I think was quite good. Right, give the flaps a chance to its... it's actually interesting. No, it's not. Oh, come on. Are we not getting flaps on the replay? Don't do this to me. Come on, come on. Ah, there they are. They're extending. And, yeah. This, I do apologise for the state of the scenery on the replays. It's a bit naff. Although, to be honest, between that and the default scenery, I mean, you can't really tell, right? Look at that. Beautiful touchdown. God, it sounds like American football. Touchdown. Touchdown. Yeah, so pretty damn good landing. Maybe, hold on. Maybe floated it a little bit, right? So once again, thank you very much for watching. Realise you had a choice of virtual flights. Thank you very much for choosing this. There, can't speak. Thank you very much for choosing this one. I wish you all a pleasant onward browsing journey, and do hope to welcome you back on board again in the very near future. So from here in Beijing, I leave you with a couple of replays. This is a massive airport. I mean, look, it's all the way over there, and we're like miles away from landing. I mean, bloody hell. I tell you what, I just always love flying to different places. Like, there are probably a lot of, I guess most flight simmers probably just do Europe and North America, right? I need to do some more South America flights, but I never seem to get rostered anything. I mean, I know I used to do quite a few Avianca flights back in the day, but for a beautiful landing. There we go. Absolutely lovely. Come on, let's get those ailerons, speed brakes. And I'll tell you what, because I like you all so much, I'm going to give you... ourselves about there, I reckon. I'm going to give you lovely people a view from the runway as we...
Don't sink.
As we come into land.
Don't sink.
So what I just need to do
Don't
is pause sink. That. Need to go there. I need to change that to free camera. I need to turn off that. I need to get train speed up. And we'll go and park ourselves. Now, for ages, I've been trying to do like a follow the aircraft thing, but it always ends up just being crap, so I'm not going to bother with that. I'll tell you what, we're just going to plonk ourselves down here somewhere. We'll zoom in. Zoom over about 96 or 95 there. And I think we sort of hit the ground somewhere around about. Let's back it off a little because we don't want to be too. There. Right. Let's see if this works. So there you go. You see us coming to land, as you can see from the windsock there, a beautifully calm day. So there's no excuse for this being a crap landing. As it happens, it was a reasonable landing. Draw distance is quite... Ah, there's the wheels. There we go. Oh, yeah, they're there. And... Yeah. Pretty damn good. There we go. And we'll see you all again in a very near future. I better just let this play for a few seconds more, otherwise the little things that stick on the end will block the view. So yeah, there we go. If you are familiar with Beijing or live in Beijing, well, first of all, hello and welcome to the channel. And secondly, can you please confirm whether those buildings at the end of the runway like that are actually, I know I could just go on Google Earth, right? But yeah, if they are actually there or not. Right, I'm off. Farewell for now, folks.